Today, first concept, test design techniques. There are two techniques available in manual testing. One is BVA. First one is BVA. BVA means bound value analysis. First one is bound value analysis. Bound value analysis means customer is said he want one user username field. That the customer is saying that username field should take minimum 4 characters, maximum 12 characters. That is the customer requirement. For example, this is a small requirement. But the customer is saying now that the username field should take minimum 9 characters, maximum 999 characters. So this is the complex. This is the very complexity. So like means we should take 999. That means we should take 990 inputs. 990 inputs. It is very difficult. If you want to take the 990 inputs, it is very difficult. If customer is saying that username field should take minimum 4 characters to maximum 12 characters, so we can test. Easily we can test. Once we will take 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. That is easy. But customer is saying that username field should take minimum 9 characters, maximum 999 characters. If we want to test that field, it will be very hard. Like, you know, we should take nearly 990 inputs. If you want to take 990 inputs, it will be very hard. It is very critical. Why? Because we should take 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, like 990 inputs, 990 inputs we should take. So it is very difficult. So in that situation, we will follow boundary value analysis. We will concentrate only on boundaries. So in this application, customer is saying this username field should take minimum 9 characters, maximum 999 characters. So here lower bound is, what is the lower bound?
9.
Lower bound minus 1?
998.
Lower bound minus 1. 8.
Oh, lower.
Lower bound plus 1.
10.
Upper bound minus 1.
998.
Upper bound.
999.
Upper one plus 1?
1000.
1000. So, in between, these values are called valid inputs. Lower bound plus 1, upper one minus 1, upper one. So, these are the valid inputs. With the help of valid inputs, if you do testing, that is called positive testing. With the help of valid inputs, if you do testing, that is called positive testing. With the help of invalid inputs, so this is lower bound minus 1, upper bound plus 1, these are the invalid inputs. With the help of invalid inputs, if you do testing, that is called negative testing. So here we will do positive testing as well as negative testing also. Positive testing we will do as well as negative testing also. A test engineer should have negative mind setup, then only he will become a good test engineer. So here we are doing positive testing as well as negative testing also. So positive testing with the help of valid inputs, if you do testing, that is positive testing. With the help of invalid inputs, if you do testing, that is called negative testing. Positive testing we will do, negative testing also we will do. Positive testing also we will do, and negative testing also we will do. So this is the bound value analysis. What is technique? A complex task solved by very simple way, that is called technique. So here we need to take nearly 990 inputs. Here we will take 990 inputs. So 990 inputs, if you want to take it, is very difficult. So just here we are taking only 6 inputs. Here we are taking only 6 inputs. With the help of only 6 inputs, if you do testing, that is called positive testing. So Here we are taking only 6 inputs ma, 4
okay,
positive inputs, 2 negative inputs. So we are not taking 9 negative inputs. So we are using, we are concentrating on only on boundaries. So that's the reason we are calling it is a boundary value analysis. So we are concentrating only on boundaries. So that's the reason we are calling it is a boundary value analysis. We are concentrating only on boundaries. So that's the reason we are calling it is a boundary value analysis. Okay. That is ma, you have any doubt in this concept, it is very very important in testing. First question in testing, that is test design techniques. First important question in testing, in manual testing, that is test design techniques. This is the first important question, test design techniques. Boundaries, boundary value analysis. We are concentrating only on boundaries. We are concentrating only on boundaries. We are concentrating only on boundaries. Next one.
This boundary value analysis 9 to 9 and then 9, we have to give that number or
characters, madam. 9 to 999 characters, madam. Once we will take 9 characters, once we will take 10 characters, one we will take 11 characters, one we need to take 12 characters, like.
Okay, the this one we have to give, sir. And
999 characters, if you want to give, so we need to count all the characters, how many characters we entered. So it is very difficult, madam. So that in that situation we will use boundary value analysis, BVA, boundary value analysis. We will concentrate only on boundaries. Okay?
Got it.
Got it. Any doubt, ma?
No, sir.
No. Right. Next one, ECP. ECP. What do you mean by ECP? Equivalent class partition. Equivalent class partition. Equally we will do partition. Equally we will do partition. For example, customer is said that username field should take minimum 4 characters, maximum 12 characters. So customer want one username field. He is saying requirement very clearly. So that username field should take minimum 4 characters, maximum 12 characters. If you take, so if you want to test this field, first of all we need to prepare the test data. One is valid data. One is valid data. Second one is invalid data. One is valid data, second one is invalid data. So greater than 4, valid, less than 4, invalid, less than 12, valid, greater than 12, invalid. Customer is saying all, yeah, that username field should take minimum 4 characters, maximum 12 characters, all letters are ABCD, small letters only, numerical letters are also applicable. This is the customer requirement. Okay, so if you take ABCD, that is valid. If you take caps ABCD, that is invalid. If you take 1 2 3 4, valid. If you take special character, plus, minus, star, dot, hash, at the rate, these are the invalid. So we will prepare valid data, invalid data. With the help of valid data, if you do testing, that is called positive testing. With the help of invalid inputs, if you do testing, that is called negative testing. You will do positive testing as well as negative testing also. You will do positive testing as well as negative testing also. With the help of valid inputs, if you do testing, that is called positive testing. With the help of invalid inputs, if you do testing, that is called negative testing. So positive testing we will do, negative testing also we will do. Positive testing we will do, negative testing also we will do. So here a test engineer, he should do positive testing as well as negative testing also. He will do, he need to do positive testing as well as negative testing. Positive testing as well as negative testing. So So a test engineer should know. He should know how to do partial testing. He should know how to do NAICS testing. He should know how to do partial testing. Here we will do valid inputs. We will take valid inputs and invalid inputs. With the help of valid inputs, if you do testing, partial testing. So with the help of valid inputs, if we do testing, that is partial testing. With the help of invalid inputs, if we do testing, we do testing. Partial testing, we will do negative testing also. We will. Partial testing we will do, negative testing also we will do. So this is equivalence class partition. Equally we are dividing. So that's the reason we are calling it a equivalence class partition. Okay, ma? These are the test to design techniques. Next pending concept is next terminology.
The boundary value analysis and equivalence class partition has the same meaning.
So there we are concentrating on the boundaries. Equivalence class partition, we will prepare valid data, invalid data. There are two techniques. Right. Next terminology. I will show you all terminology terms. What are the terms in manual testing? We will discuss. I will explain you. So, no need to write all those things. If you want write, it will take more time. So, first terminology. These are the two pending concepts, madam. Test to design techniques and the terminology. First one, defective products. First one, defective products. If at all the product is not justifying the sum of the requirements, but still it is usable. So such type of defects is known as defective products. For example, I bought one car. So car backside one scratch is there, but still car is running, car is working. So that type of defects is called defect products. Next, defective products. I bought one car. Okay, it is not working. At the same time, it is not justifying the customer requirement. Customer is said car should be very clean and it should be very neat. It should be new car. But some scratch is there, okay, leave it. But still it is not working. So such type of defects is known as defective products. Defective products means, so just not justifying the customer requirements, but we can use them. So such type of defects is called defective products. Second one is, not only justifying the customer requirements, it is not usable. Such type of defects is called defective products. Got it? Madam?
Yes, sir.
What is the main difference between defective products and defective products?
Defect products means just only some equipment.
Not satisfying you, but it is working.
It is working. But defective product, it is not working and it is not justifying also.
Justifying also. Right. Great, ma'am. Right. Next, quality assurance, QA and QC. There are two types of people in the software company. Quality assurance people and quality control people. Quality assurance is the one of the department. So each and every software company will maintain. They will check each and every phase output document is properly coming or not. Each and every phase output document is properly coming or not. And each and every role in the organization according to customer expectation working or not, they will check. So that is called quality assurance. QA people means quality assurance people. Each and every role in the organization according to customer expectation working or not. Each and every role in the organization and each and every phase output document properly coming or not, they will check. That is called quality assurance people. Next, quality control, QC. So the people after developing the application, based on the customer requirement, based on the company requirement, that that application is developed or not, they will do testing. So that is why, that's why that is called quality control. So there are two types of people: quality assurance, quality control. We are QA people, quality assurance people. NCR, next one, NCR. NCR means non-confirmation rate. Whenever you are working with any software company, the company will be give you after doing any irreparable mistakes. Reparable mistakes means after doing mistake we can rectify or we can solve the problem. That is called reparable mistakes. If you do irreparable mistakes, so irreparable mistakes means we will not rectify that problem. So that mistakes is called irreparable mistakes. If you do irreparable mistakes, each and every software company give you penalty or punishment. That is called NCR. NCR is nothing but non-confirmation rate. Next, inspection. Inspection means without giving any clear intimation, they will come and they will do checking on roles or departments. That is called inspection. They will not give any clear intimation. Directly they will come and they will do checking on roles or departments. Roles or departments. That is called inspection. Next, audit. Audit means they will give clear information very advanced, and they will come and they will do testing. They will do checking or checking on departments or roles. That is called audit. Here two types of audits: internal audit to external audit. Internal audit means internal resources they will do. External audit means external outside company people will come and they will do check. So that is the external audit. Next, CAPA, corrective actions and preventive actions. CA means corrective actions. After doing maintenance, preventive actions means after doing that mistake we can't reparable. That is called preventive action. In future it will not happen. Just we need to check. That is preventive action. Corrective actions means we can correct the problem or issue or mistake. Preventive actions means we can't solve that problem, we can't rectify that problem. That is called preventive action. Next, SCM, software configuration management. There are two things: one is change control and the second one is version control. Already discussed. 10th one, common repository. Common repository is nothing but it is a storage place where we can store the total company information.
So all the project information we will store in repository. If you get any similar project, we will use this information. We can complete that particular task very easily. That is called reference archive. So each and every software company compulsory they will maintain common repository. Examples: VSS, Visual Source Safe, CVS, concurrent version system. Baseline project means finalized project information. Publishing. Before delivering the application, they will store in common repository. Specialized presentation. So ICS bank project. So we did this also here. So that product information they will store. Before delivering the project, they will store in common repository. Special icon representation. Release. It is a process sending the application from development department to testing department.
So R, we can say one company to market. So recently iPhone people, they released new iPhone version is i10 or iPhone i9 i10, we can say. So that is called release.
Development department, SME department, or company to market, that is called release. When the new car released, we will say when the new model released. So that is release.
Next two, delivery. Delivery means, so after developing the application, we need to deploy the application to client environment. That is delivery.
Company to market.
Not company to market, delivery. So market to client, market to client. So that is called delivery. So you ordered 100 computers. So I am delivering in your home. So that is delivery. So that is the main difference between release and delivery. Okay. Next, SRN, software release note. So these people, the technical department people will be prepared this document, SRN, software release note. So we will send it to testing department. In this document we have some information like build path information, known issues path information, test data path information, deployment document path information, and release manager name, release date, build name, version number, build number, module name, project name, everything they will store in. They will store in that note, that is called SRN, software release note. It is a note prepared by technical department people and sending to testing department people. And in this document we have some following fields like so test data path information, known issues path information, and deployment document path information, and release manager name, build number, version number, release date, project name, everything they will store in one note. That is called SRN. That is called SRN, software release note. Next, SDN, software delivery note. Software delivery note. It is a note prepared by some technical department people only. Software delivery note. During delivery, we need to provide some documents. What are the documents we need to provide? You will listed out. They will listed out here in this section. That is user manual and known issues document. User manual means how to after delivering the application, how to work with. Without any support, we can do some things, some small things. So he will listed out here in this section. Known issues. So what are the problems we can face? He will listed out here in this section. That is called known issues. Review. Review means process of studying or process of checking. Process of studying or process of checking. Okay. So next, review report. While doing review, if you have any doubt, we will list it out in one report. That is called a review report. List of doubts we will write in review report. Peer review. Peer review means colleague review. Colleague will do the review. So after doing review, after doing review, so he will listed out some points. That is called review report. That is called review report. Slip page. So for example, so I gave one work. So you should complete this work in 8 hours. But if you take 10 hours, so 2 hours is slip page. Extra time to complete that particular work. Slip page means extra time to complete that work. Escalation. Escalation means each and every software company, they will conduct some formal meetings. So in that formal meetings, what they will do? So they will intimate the information to one level to other level. So that's the reason we can say escalator. Escalator means one level to other level we will go. So here escalation is nothing but just like we will pass the information to one level to other level. That is called escalation. Metrics means already discussed. It is a measurement. Traceability matrix. Traceability matrix I will tell you later with example. Next, prototype. prototype means if we want to take the requirements and if we want to give the requirements, so we will use prototype. That means it is a roughly and roughly developed model which is used for if you want to take the requirements, if you want to give the requirements, we will use this prototype model. Benchmark. So we will use, usually we will compare to purpose, we will use this one, benchmark. It is a one of the terminology point, so it is also very important. Usually we will compare, just you like a Mahesh Bhav, just you are you did work as a level 5 company, so you did work as a one expert, so just usually we will compare, we will use this one benchmark. Change request. In the FRS, customer will give some requirements. After giving the requirements, middle of the project, if he want change the requirements, each and every software company, they will provide change the request template. Using the template only, he can change the requirements. So, using that template, he will raise the request. Sir, sir, actually I said 2 buttons, but I need 3 buttons. That is called change the request template. Impact analysis. Sometimes if you do change request template, if you request to company, sometimes will accept, sometimes will not accept. Why? Because if you do any changes, after if it is developed, they will not accept that request. Why? Because that application already developed. So if it is developed, they will not accept. If it is not developed, then they will take the request. Otherwise, they will not take the request. Test suite. It is a combination of regression test cases and retest cases. It is a combination of regression test cases and retest cases. It is a combination of regression test cases and retest cases. Test bed. It is a combination of test suite and test environment. Test bed is nothing but it is a combination of test environment and test suite. Defect is. Defect is. After finding the defect, and closing the defect, how many days? So that is called a defect age. Defect age is nothing but what is the time between finding the defect and closing the defect. So that is called a defect age. Latent defect. After raising the defect, if they release any new build, that is called a latent defect. That is called a latent defect. After finding the defect, if they release any build, that is called latent. Walkthrough means informal meetings. Walkthrough means informal meetings. Each and every role in the organization, they will participate in this meeting. Just they will share the information to all the high level authorities as well as low level authorities. They will share the information. They will conduct, why they are conducting the meeting, so also project team, so how we can do. So just they will conduct informal meetings, so that is walkthroughs. Friday or Monday they will conduct. Some companies will conduct Friday. Some companies will conduct Monday. Code value. After writing the code. So code is correct or not. So they will check it. That is called code value. Code value. After writing the code, developers they will write the code. After writing the code, this code is correct or not. They will check it. That is called code value. Code optimization. Or you can say fine tuning also. After writing the code, if it is code is not good, then they will do some changes. So that is called fine tuning. So previously we have one TV. So if you do tune correctly, then it will picture will come very neatly. Otherwise it will not come, some shades or some disturbances will come. So if you do fine tune, so it will be very good. So just like fine tuning, and they will rectify the problems. That is called code active or fine tuning. Next, PPM, periodic project meeting. So in this meeting, high level management people will be participate. Only the project management people. So team leader, project manager, test engineers, everything, they will participate in this meeting. In this meeting, they will discuss how much percentage covered in this project and how much percentage not covered. Task, what are the tasks completed, total defects and slippages, reasons for slippages, technical issues, HR related issues, they will discuss in this meeting. That is PPM, periodic project meeting. Periodic project meeting. Next PPR. PPR is project report. During that project meeting, we will discuss. They will discuss some points. What are the points they discuss? We will list it out here in this section. That is called PPR. PPR project report. Next MOM. Minutes of meeting. MOM means minutes of meeting. So after conducting the meetings, what are the points they discussed? So main points they will listed out here in this section, that is called MOM, minutes of meeting. So they will conduct some like ministers meeting conducted. So after meeting they will discuss what they discussed. He will listed out in the section that is called MOM, minutes of meeting. Next MRM, management representation meeting. It is very very important. So here high level management people, total company people will be participate in this meeting. In this meeting, success rate, growth rate of the company, projects that are recently signed up or recently completed, projects that are in pipeline, continuing, customers appraisals, customers need to comments, and everything he will listed out. Future plans, internal audit reports, external audit reports, he will listed out in this section. Last one, patch. So whenever we are raising the defective, then developers will rectify the problem and they will send him to testing department. That means they are not developing newly. So already whenever we are raising the defective, they are rectifying the problem and they are sending the same build, but they are rectifying the problem. That is called patch. Patch. That is called patch. These are the terms regularly we will use in software companies.